Now let's start here with the desktop computer many of us have spent countless hours working with to build and use software. It looks conventional and familiar only because we've each spent so much time with it. But something you'll notice about all these devices when you look at them without anything else in the picture. It's hard to see the human. Now, one of my favorite thought experiments is by the VR pioneer, Jerian Lanier. You may have heard this before, so just bear with me for a moment. What if aliens came to Earth and people were nowhere to be found? And what if these aliens tried to figure out what we were like based on our computers? What would they think? I mean, do we have 102 fingers and one big eye? Now, if they looked at a hammer, we'd make more sense. You can almost see the arm that would wield this tool and hammer in nails. But this computer? I mean, just look at that keyboard. It's not really built for us. In fact, it's not even built for us to type fast. Back when this keyboard layout was designed, it was intended to keep us from typing so fast that these type bars would get caught together and screw everything up. But this is what evolved into the modern keyboard. Now, this is a very physical difference between a person and a machine. Let's look at a less physical difference that's just as dangerous. Now, what's wrong with this picture? In many ways, this is our relationship to technology today. It gives us a lot of value. However, we're adapting our lifestyle to the technology that assists us. And there's a heavy cost: distraction. We pay that cost frequently. But what if we didn't have to?